Welcome to St. Thomas Aquinas for our funeral mass this morning for Jack Miller. Thank you all for your presence here today. Your presence means more than words can say. Especially, I would like to thank the Middleton High School community for your outpouring of love and support to the families of Simon, Evan, and Jack. Thank you also to Father Brian Wilk, pastor of St. Bernard's in Middleton, who is celebrating the Mass for Jack this morning and who represents the entire parish family of St. Bernard's. We also welcome and acknowledge all of those who are joining us in the live stream of the Mass today. Thank you for praying with us and for being with us in spirit. Perhaps I could just tell you a little bit about our funeral liturgy that we are about to begin. I hope everyone had a chance to pick up the program. The family has chosen all of the songs and all of the readings for the funeral mass, and you can follow along by following this program. The numbers of the hymns chosen by the family are put in the program, and we'll be singing from this purple One in Faith hymnal that you can find in the pew. Also, I would like to mention during this pandemic time that we have installed an iWave air purifying system in the church and this building, and so the air is very clean and safe here. For those who are Catholic and who come forward for Holy Communion, we ask that you please come forward in Holy Communion and place your hands flat so we can place the host on your hand. Also, if you're a brother or sister joining us from other Christian denominations, we invite you forward as well for a blessing. You can come forward in the communion lines and place your hands on your shoulders, and we will offer you the blessing. During the sign of peace today, we ask everyone to please offer the sign of peace by waving. At this time, I would like to invite Jack's family to please come forward. John and Lori and Sarah, they have prepared a tribute today for their son and brother.
Dear Jack, I want the world to know your story and how special and loved you were. About 19 years ago, your dad and I were at an event and talked about wanting to have another baby. Sarah was the perfect daughter, and we knew we wanted a son. That night, we came up with your name, John Kepley Miller. Your dad didn't want you to be a junior, so John, after your dad and my dad, and Kepley to honor your dad's dad, as that is Grandpa Miller's middle name and his mother's family name. But we wanted to call you Jack, like my dad. We loved naming you after these great men and knew you would grow up to be great like them. But to us, you were always Jack, or Jack-Jack from The Incredibles, as the Arianos coined you. We had a monkey theme for your room as a baby, so to me, you were always my monkey. And also because you climbed on everything and you clung to me. You were a happy, easy baby with lots of energy. You always had a blanket with you, one of the many crocheted ones your Grandma Sharon made for you. Even as a 17-year-old, your blanket provided you comfort and peace. I asked your best friend Mason the other day if you still brought those to sleepovers like you did when you were young, and he said no. It's good. But Mason did confirm you always loved your own special pillow, and that went with you to every sleepover and every trip that we took. In school, your teachers always said you got your work done fast so you could either help other kids or entertain them. You never met a kid you didn't like, and you always made friends so easily. You were active in sports from an early age, with hockey and soccer being your favorites. You loved music, all music and played the piano from the time you were four and bass since middle school. And of course, a little much to my dismay, you loved those video games and your phone. Your video games were a good social outlet to stay connected to your friends in North Dakota, Indiana, and then here in Madison. Because you were immunocompromised, this past year of the pandemic was so hard for you to be locked up. Taking away your social connections was harder for you than all the years of horrific treatments you went through with leukemia, pancreatitis, and HSP. Lately, we might have tussled a bit over spending more time studying, cleaning your room, washing your clothes, just once a month is all I asked, or making decisions. But your mantra was to be happy and enjoy life. It was almost as if you knew your life was going to be cut short in some way, and you needed to make the most of every moment. We know you loved us, but your friends were your passion. You would do anything for them at any time. You would pay for their food. You would give them jerseys. You would drive to work. Whatever they needed, you were there. Your smile, your dimples, your adventurous spirit, laughter, and charm were contagious. And while you lived with three pretty judgy, critical people in your house, you saw the good in everyone. While you would tell us how different you were from the three of us, we needed your carefree, chill personality. You gave us perspective, balance, laughter, and joy. While you didn't always go to church or love going to church, sorry, Father, but you were a child of God, and your faith was important to you. You wore your cross necklace every day with pride and love. Your cross necklace is the only thing that survived the crash, and we will treasure this gift from you always. I hope for so many things in your future for you, Jack. College, career, your home, a wife, children, and a long, healthy life. And you talked about these too. And knowing your tastes for really expensive things, I knew you were gonna live well. I always thought you probably had to marry up and marry a doctor to support you, but we weren't there yet, so. But most importantly, I knew you would always be loved and love others. And my heart is crushed that we will never share these things with you. I love you, Jack, with all my heart. I'm so proud of who you were as a person. I will miss your nightly hugs, kisses, and love you, Mom. See you tomorrow. And as one of our favorite children's book goes, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be.
Dear Jack, if I had you here today, the first thing I would say is how much I love you. Not to be dramatic, but the love I had for you is unique to you. No other human on earth will ever compare. I don't want to say you were my best friend because being my brother was so much more than that. I don't know what I'm going to do with all of this love I have now that you're gone. I think it will just feel like a part of me is empty, like a spout so full of water it is forced to leak. Jack, I'm going to miss sharing memories with you. Do you remember when I made you switch clothes with me and walk downstairs to show our parents? You looked so good in a dress. Or when I overheard some teacher saying, you weren't a kid if you didn't make yourself a human burrito, and then I ran home and rolled you up like a human burrito because I wanted to make sure we had a childhood. Or when we beat Lego Star Wars together, Mom said that was the best we'd ever gotten along. Man, we worked hard. The teamwork was impeccable, and we beat it. Or remember those late night talks? We only had a couple of them, and at one point you asked if we could have another. But me being me, I said no, I was tired, and you didn't ask again. I would give anything in the world to have one of those late night talks with you. I only want to bring up your battle with cancer for a little bit, because I want you to know how proud I was, and still am, of how you overcame it. And tell you that I wasn't there as much as I should have been, because I was so scared, and it caused me so much pain to see you like that. Of course, now I would go through all that pain 1,000 times just to tell you about how much I love you and give you a hug. In high school, you changed so much. In many ways, I miss that little boy that followed me everywhere and wanted to do anything. But in other ways, I was proud of you picking your own path. You faced so many challenges, yet you decided to go out and live your best life every day and always had buddies with you to celebrate. I'll miss those car rides to school with you. Sorry about the road rage. And you picking music you knew I like. I'm probably going to miss you most on vacations and family dinners. In so many ways, you are my rock. Who am I going to look at when mom and dad don't know simple words or how to copy and paste? Or ask what TikTok is? Who is going to join me surfing or ziplining or scuba diving or jumping off bridges? You are my person for that, and I need you. How am I going to go through life by myself? All I've known is life with you. Jack, you were destined for greatness. I just knew you'd be successful in whatever you did, and I knew you'd be the first one to settle down and give mom and dad some grandchildren. I was counting on you for that. You would have been a wonderful father, willing to do anything and everything for your wife and kids, and I was so excited to meet them, and we'd all be one big happy family at the holidays. Jack, my adventure buddy, my fighter, my brother, to the boy you were, the man you were becoming, and the man you would have been. I'm so grateful for the life you lived, and so happy I was able to be a part of it. I will love you forever and miss you for the rest of my days.
Hey, Jack, I love you. I love how you enriched our family. I love how much you adored and supported your sister. You may not have expressed your feelings to her in those words, but you did with me. I love how you playfully tormented your mom, and how with a word or look or hug, you could fill her soul with happiness. I think that was the key with you. You made people happy. You helped fill their souls. And you did it because it was who you were. It was natural for you, and something we noticed when you were young. Some are born with extraordinary talents. This was yours. I was really looking forward to more journeys and adventures with you. Most were great. The soccer and hockey trips in the Dakotas, Minnesota, Wisconsin, Kentucky, Pennsylvania, Ohio, Indiana, listening to your music, eating bad travel food, watching you win and lose with your friends. You wanted to win, and more importantly, you wanted to enjoy the experiences. I loved spending our time together. You had stitches in your ankle from hockey, a slashed head from the neighbor kids, a broken foot from tripping on the stairs, a broken wrist from soccer, concussion, also from hockey, pancreatitis, maybe from the reaction of the cancer treatment, HSP, whatever that is, still haven't had a doctor be able to explain it correctly, and leukemia. The last one was tough, and I mean very tough, very high risk kind of stuff. It robbed you of part of your childhood. You were resilient and endured and did treatment without complaining. It was amazing. The doctors and nurses loved you, and again, who doesn't? They didn't like me as much. I seemed to fulfill the scared and angry parent role a little too much with them. And you would remind me of that. It was your subtle way of asking me to be kinder. Spending that time with you showed me how strong and kind you were. It also meant we watched a lot of the Food Network when we were in the hospital. hospital. You were a great travel companion, and I was looking forward to trips to Australia and Japan or wherever else you wanted to go. As long as we went to a great steak restaurant, of course, found an aquarium, and I didn't make you go to a museum, you were good. You always wanted the adventure. You taught me things about life that I didn't expect. I learned about expensive food, expensive clothing, expensive cars and shoes, none of which matched his or our bank account. So it was, I also learned to care, support, and give people a little grace, because we all need it. I love you. You are a special, loving son, and you enriched my life. As we said nightly to each other, see you tomorrow.
Please stand and face the entryway of the church as we greet the family this morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, John died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. At this time, the family will now place on the casket this white baptismal garment. Please see in this white garment the outward sign of Jack's Christian dignity. May he bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. The family will now place on the casket Jack's baptismal garment that he wore as his family brought him to the church and united him to Jesus Christ and to the eternal life. At this time, the family will also be placing on the casket this crucifix. This crucifix reminds us of Jesus' saving act for us, also reminding us of the cross that Jack wore around his neck and the cross that we carry in this sad time, the cross that leads us to resurrection and new life. At this time, I'd like to invite everyone to please join in singing the opening song. It's Be Not Afraid. It's number 774, number 774.
You shall speak your
Let us pray. Lord, your wisdom governs the length of our days. We mourn the loss of Jack, whose life has passed so quickly, and we entrust him to your mercy. Welcome him into your heavenly dwelling and grant him the happiness of everlasting youth. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated now as we listen to God's holy word in sacred scripture.
A reading from the Book of Lamentations. My soul is deprived of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell myself my future is lost, all that I had hoped for from the Lord. The thought of my homeless poverty is wormwood and gall. Remembering it over and over leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as my reasons to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They're renewed each morning, so great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The darkness falls. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we must also love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him, and he in us, and that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now, Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die." "Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. To John and Lori and Sarah, to all of your family and your relatives, to all of your friends, on behalf of our whole community of Middleton and Madison, our Catholic families of St. Thomas Aquinas and St. Bernard's, please know of our heartfelt sympathy and prayers for you in this time of pain and sorrow as we pray our goodbye today to your beloved son and brother, grandson, nephew, cousin, and friend to so many, John Jack Kepley Miller. As you have said, Lori and John, this is an awful tragedy that never should have happened. It is not right, and it is not fair. What happened is the result of a human being's free will to make choices, and it has taken the lives of 3 precious and wonderful young men, Simon, Evan, and your son, Jack. Our hearts, our love, and our prayers go out to all of those affected, especially the families of these 3 teenagers. There are absolutely no words that I can say to take away the heartache that you feel. There's nothing that we can do to change the situation that we are in. We are at a complete loss for words. But our presence is our way of reassuring you that you are loved and that we are walking with you. Thank you for your expression of love in the beautiful tribute, the beautiful letters that you wrote to Jack and that you shared with us before Mass this morning. Jack was truly blessed with the very best mom, the very best dad, and the very best sister anyone could ever have. The love you have for Jack and the love he has for you and the family memories that you share can never be taken away. It is important for us today that even though we are overwhelmed with the pain of Jack's sudden death, we can celebrate his amazing life among us and thank God for the gift that Jack was to all who knew him. Jack was a happy young person, full of life and love, and had an adventurous spirit. As the family describes, and as Sarah told us, Jack was her adventure buddy. He loved traveling with his family, and he tried everything, surfing and snorkeling, whitewater rafting, and even jumping off bridges. He was loved by his fellow Middleton High School soccer teammates, and he enjoyed hockey as well, and was a member of the Middleton Wings hockey program. Jack was easygoing, charming, handsome, faith-filled, generous, purposefully positive, resilient, smart, kind, funny, athletic, musical, and certainly had a bright future ahead of him. His dream was to attend the University of Wisconsin here in Madison, just like his big sister, and to be roommates with his best friend, Mason. Jack was blessed with very many friends and had a great group of close friends, as well as friends from many diverse backgrounds. His closest friends, especially Mason, Evan, and Simon, were his passion, and he loved making them laugh. He was so genuinely kind and thoughtful of others. He even stayed in touch with friends he grew up with in other states and made friendships with his cousins and second cousins. In 2017, when Jack was in seventh grade, he was diagnosed with leukemia. Lori and John spent a lot of time with Jack in the hospital and going to treatments and appointments. During the time he was fighting his illness, Jack never complained, and he tried to reassure his parents that he would be okay. He remained positive, even to the point of joking with his nurses and keeping the mood upbeat when the situation became scary, serious, and worrisome. Everyone was so grateful in 2020 when Jack completed his treatments and was declared a leukemia survivor. Jack enjoyed life and lived life to the fullest. He loved boating and fishing with his dad, all water sports and going out to eat, especially ordering the steak and critiquing the food. Jack enjoyed all kinds of music and enjoyed playing the bass in the orchestra, as well as singing loudly in his car. Jack loved his parents and his sister, and they each shared a special bond with him. Remembering Jack's wonderful life among us makes today an especially difficult day. Life will never be the same without him. In our sorrow and grief, we turn to Jesus in this funeral mass, and Jesus comforts us with his presence in the Word of God, in the scripture readings chosen by the family, in all of those present at this mass, and in the sacrament of the Eucharist. Jesus is here. Jesus is present. In life, Jack loved the Lord Jesus, and he had a deep faith in Jesus Christ. His parents planted the seeds of faith in him and brought him to the church to be baptized into the life of Christ and into the family of God. Jack grew up in love for Jesus, and as he celebrated his first Holy Communion, and then became an altar server at Sunday Mass with his sister. As a member of our St. Thomas Aquinas family, Jack was confirmed and received the gift of the Holy Spirit and allowed the Spirit to guide him in his life. Jack felt called to attend Frasati Fest retreat weekend with his friends from church so that he could grow stronger in his faith. He wore a cross around his neck every day and was filled with the joy of believing. We know by faith that our Creator God does not abandon us. We also know by faith that we do not follow a God who is indifferent to our sufferings and who is too aloof to simply allow bad things to happen to good people with no care or concern for us. During his illness, Jack never blamed God, but felt God was helping him. The cross he wore was a way of reminding him that Jesus was with him, and Jesus knows what it is like to suffer. On the cross, Jesus enters into our suffering, and in his resurrection, he gives us the gift of eternal life and the victory over every sin and even death and all the agonies and sorrows of this imperfect world. The readings proclaimed today at Jack's funeral mass remind us of God's love for us, even in the midst of our darkest days. We must always remember love has won, not evil, not death. Love has won. Like Jesus' agony in the garden before his crucifixion on Good Friday, when Jesus asked for the cup of suffering to be removed from him, it seemed like God had abandoned him. As he died on the cross, it seemed God was silent and aloof. But then came the next day, the day when Jesus Christ rose from the dead and saved us for eternal life, conquering every sin and even death. That is the day love won. The lament today, like in the first reading, is the lament that we cry out to God, telling God, we forgot what happiness means. We are downcast, and we are losing our hope. But we are reminded that the favors of the Lord are not exhausted. God's mercies are not spent. They are renewed each morning. And somehow, God will save us from this hour. The evil in this world is never the Lord of the last day. Because the last day is the day of resurrection, and that day is God's victory. But so often the day right before the last day, like Good Friday, the suffering is so great. It seems like there is no hope and that God is so far away. But the Lord is near. The Lord is here. And on the last day, God solves everything. God is the Lord of the last day. The victory on the last day belongs to God alone, who saves us. The second reading underscores this promise of victory and points out that those who remain in the love of God remain in God. The sign that we remain in God is how we love one another. In life, Jack loved the Lord and he loved others, his family, his friends, his school, and even strangers. He shared his love through his generosity and kindness. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The gospel scene is one that we can relate to, especially as Martha and Mary lamented the death of their brother Lazarus. We echo their sentiment. Lord, if you had been here, our brother would not have died. We send out this prayer today as well to Jesus. Where are you? And Jesus responds, as he does in the gospel, to reassure us, your brother will rise. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? And we say with Martha and with Jack, because he certainly believed as well, yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. So what is next for us as we go forward from Jack's funeral mass? How would Jack want us to move forward in our lives? How would Jesus want us to move forward in the days ahead? I want to share with you a true story that might possibly suggest an answer to these questions. It is the story of Puccini, the great Italian composer of famous operas. It seems that when Puccini was fairly young, he contracted cancer, and so he decided to spend his last days writing his final opera. When his friends would say to him, "You are sick and ailing. Take it easy and rest," Puccini would always respond, "I am going to do as much as I can on my great masterpiece, and then it's up to you, my friends, to finish it if I don't." Well, as you suspected, Puccini died before the opera was finished. Now his friends and peers had a choice. They could wallow in grief and anger and mourn their friend and return to life as usual. Or they could go forward, even in their sorrow, and build on his melody and his work and complete what he started. Thank God they chose the latter. And so in 1926, Puccini's final opera was played for the very first time, conducted by his friend Arturo Toscanini. When it came to the part of the opera where the master Puccini had stopped because of his death, Toscanini stopped everything. He turned around with eyes welling up with tears and said to the huge audience, "This is where the master ends." Then, after a few moments, he lifted up his head, smiled broadly, and said, "And this is where his friends began." And he finished the beautiful opera. You can see the point of the story. What are we going to do about this tragedy that took Jack from us? What are we going to do about Jack's unfinished masterpiece that he left us by how he lived his life? Every human being and every human life can leave a wonderful and distinct impression and unique legacy to this world of ours. We can use our time here to spread love and hope and make life beautiful. I would suggest that if there is any fitting response to the shock and devastation of Jack's death, it is that life, our lives, should be a life that is lived to the fullest, a life lived more selflessly, a life that makes a difference for others, a life that makes beautiful music for Jack and for our Lord Jesus Christ. Across the chasm of death, you can make, in a real sense, Jack live again. The music does not have to stop here today. We have a choice, as did Puccini's friends. choose to finish Jack's masterpiece. What can we do to continue Jack's legacy? Though Jack's life on earth was cut way too short, the 17 years of his life were not wasted. Jack lived an amazing, resilient, happy, faith-filled life, a life full of family, friendships, good memories, love, and faith. John, Lori, and Sarah, you will never forget the 17 years spent with your son and brother, 17 years of knowing a very special and gifted loved one. And no one here will ever forget Jack either. Jesus will help us to cope with this tragic loss in the days ahead. And Jesus will also help us to complete the great work, the great masterpiece that Jack has begun. Please stand. My sisters and brothers, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We now join our prayers to his. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
In baptism, John Kepley received the light of Christ. We lovingly ask that you, O Lord, scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Jack was nourished at the table of the Savior. May you, Lord of all mercy, welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And many friends and members of our families, including Simon and Evan, have gone before us and may await your kingdom. We ask that you grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we give thanks for Jack's love, his friendship, and his adventurous spirit. May you, O Lord, continue to provide us with faith-filled companions for our journeys. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them into the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we are assembled here in faith and in confidence to pray for our brother Jack. We ask that you strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated now as we prepare the altar for the celebration of the Eucharist.
We sing together number 698. Number 698.
Thank you.
please stand. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, John, Jack, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Please kneel or be seated according to your custom. At this time, we will now be praying the ancient Eucharistic prayer. As Catholics, we believe during this prayer, the bread and wine become the body and blood of Jesus. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God, in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. My Lord and my God, the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Thomas Aquinas and Saint John, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in charity, in faith and charity, your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Donald, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Jack, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Please stand. As Jack so often did in his life, at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
By waving, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Please kneel or be seated according to your custom. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Our communion hymn is number 789, number 789.
At this time, we'll now have the distribution of Holy Communion. There'll be four lines for Holy Communion in this part of the church. There'll be two lines here in the middle, and then one line over by the Stations of the Cross on the wall over there, and the fourth line over here by this wall by the Stations of the Cross over there. We'll also have a distributor of Holy Communion in the upstairs area as well. At this time, we invite forward all of those for Holy Communion. As you come forward, you can receive Holy Communion by putting your hand out flat like this. If you're a brother or sister joining us from another Christian denomination, we invite you forward at this time as well for a blessing. Simply come forward in the communion line, place your hands on your shoulders like this, and we will offer you the blessing. The body of Christ.
Do you need the
The body of Christ. Just in case. I don't know. It's right in there. I put it on the altar. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Are you going upstairs?
Raise you upon eagle's wings, bear you on the ground.
Please stand and let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Jack may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Again, on behalf of the family, thank you so much, everyone, for your presence here today. It means more than words can say. Immediately after Mass, all are invited and welcome to come outside into our courtyard for the final prayer. And then after that, all are invited to come back into the social hall where we will be serving the reception. And we're grateful for the University of Wisconsin who is catering the reception today. And we are going to be asking people to go into the line for food right away and be seated at the tables after they get their food. And so thanks again for your presence. Also want to thank Father Brian Wilk of St. Bernard's in Middleton for his presence and his concelebration of the Mass today for Jack. Thank you, Father Brian. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Jack, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Jack again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
There is
Jack, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
We go forth singing number 576, Amazing Grace, number 576.